Hey guys, so today I'm going to show you how I make my sorrel wine. What you're gonna need is 2 pounds of sugar, brown and white, 1 packet of yeast, and I'm using bread yeast, a small cup, a large bowl, a large bottle, I think that's called a funnel, a strainer, and a juice cup. So this is the sorrel that's already been boiled, and we're just gonna add it to the bowl, strain it into the bowl, and it's actually back at room temperature, so it's not hot. You don't want to use it while it's hot. Okay, so now we're going to add the sugar, and I'm actually going to add the entire 2 pounds of sugar, but I'm not adding all at once. Now, depending on the amount of sorrel you're using, then you may not need to add 2 pounds, but I like my wine sweet. So now that the sugar's been dissolved, I'm going to pour all contents into the bottle. So now we are going to add the yeast, and like I said before, this is approximately, let's say, 1 packet of yeast. I'm going to shake this twice to get activate the yeast, and for the first day I'm going to tighten it, but then for the second day I'm going to release the cap so that the gas can be released without taking it off completely, and I'm going to release the gas every day until it stops bubbling, and then that's when you know it's ready. But about 7 or 8 days it should be ready. Okay, and this is it at 4 days later, and as you can see, the yeast is still very active and working, and you can see all the bubbles, they're still going. So I'm just going to give this a few more days, and then I'm going to strain it and sugar it to my tasting and put it in the fridge for about another week. This is what it should look like after 4 days.